Show yourself approved. I've studied all the holy books, the Vedas, the Quran, the Bible, and each of them speak about Jesus being born of a virgin. Now this means that he had no human father. The Quran says it, the Vedas says it, and the Bible says it. The three main holy books, the three main religions in the world testify that the Son of God was born of a virgin. And the three of them testify about Jesus' death and resurrection. So it's time to open your eyes. I've done my study. I've read these books. I've bowed my knee before the King. For King's the Lord of Lords. His name is Misha. In the Vedas, his name is Yeshua HaMashiach in the Hebrew. His name is Jesus Christ in the English. The name means the deliverer and salvation of the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, of God, the creator of the universe. The Bible testifies that God himself is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. When you repent and you ask Jesus into your life, you receive salvation, you receive Jesus Christ, you receive the Holy Spirit. I've met many Christians that said, oh, we've said the sinner's prayer, we didn't feel anything. We go to church every week, but we're not sure if we're saved. Jesus' name means deliverer and salvation. Have you met the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords? Do you think he's God because he's all the wars on the earth? Or is it because of man's sin? Is it because of man's rebellion against God that these things happen? Because everyone has free choice. Adolf Hitler chose to kill the gypsies and the Jews and the homosexuals. It's his choice. People make choices and they reap the rewards of these choices. We are born free. We might die free or we might die slaves or bond or whatever. But the laws in this land speak about freedom. These were put there by the forefathers. They give us freedom of speech, freedom of religion, freedom of choice. But there are other laws out there in the world that want to subvert you into slavery. Especially women. That's right, we're talking about the Islamic laws that's exercised in many countries in the world. And even it says in the Quran, it speaks in the Quran about Jesus' death and resurrection. Surah 355, if you turn to that in your Quran, Surah 355 says, Jesus, this is God speaking, Jesus, I shall cause you to die. I shall contend against those who have contended against you until the resurrection. Now how would you interpret that as a Muslim, as a Christian, as an atheist? Well, let me tell you how I would interpret that. God is saying to Jesus, he's going to cause him to die. He's going to contend against them who contend against him until the resurrection. And then if you turn to Surah 19, verse 33, Jesus himself speaks, blessed is the day I die. Blessed is the day I'll be resurrected from the dead. Now apparently Jesus was a prophet in the Quran. And when a prophet speaks, it's usually a prophecy about something happening in the future.
far as I understand. So what I interpret from that is Jesus was prophesying of his death and his resurrection. That's what I interpret from that. I don't need an imam, I don't need a pope, I don't need a religious person to tell me what these holy books say. Me as a free man, I can pick these up, I can study them, and I can identify my Lord and my King. Even within the Vedas, it talks about the Prajapati sacrifice. This is when the chief of the gods sends a part of himself to die for the sins of his people. And out of the millions of Hindu gods that Hindu people worship, only one person out of these millions and millions of gods fulfilled that role. His name is written in the Vedas, Yesha Mesha. The Hebrew, Yeshua HaMashiach. In the English, Jesus Christ. Okay? I studied other religions. If you study the star constellations, and if you begin with what's called Virgo, the Virgin, and you end with Leo, the Lion, what does that tell us? The Messiah, the King of the Universe, would be born through a virgin, and he would return as the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the all-conquering Lion of the tribe of Judah. Just as the scriptures say, just as the prophets said, Prophet Isaiah, Prophet Jeremiah, Hosea, all the prophets right throughout the entire scriptures prophesied of this man, Jesus Christ, who had fulfilled the law and the prophets. Question is, do you know him as your Lord and Savior? He made himself known to us. He came in a human body. He came as a carpenter, even though he created the universe. He came as a humble carpenter, born through a virgin, to die on the cross, to take away the sin of the entire world. And it says in Isaiah 53, who is willing to believe our reports? Read that entire chapter of Isaiah 53, and it speaks of the suffering servant. Jesus was the suffering servant from the tribe of Judah. Except the Jews were looking for the all-conquering king the first time, but he came the first time to take away the sin of the world. That's why he came. The second time he comes is to redeem his people. When God pours out his wrath on the earth, which it more than deserves, the earth more than deserves God's wrath, but he's very patient. He wants people to come to him and repent of their sin. You know, there's things happening on this earth I wish I could do something about, that you read in the newspapers, and I can only do so much as a free man. Hallelujah. The Apostle Paul says, when you follow Jesus Christ, he's a willing bond servant to the Lord Jesus. King David said, if I go to the highest heavens, or if I go to the lowest parts of the earth, you shall be there. Because he had faith in God's love. Faith in who God is. God wants to save your soul. God more than loves you. He provided the Lamb that takes away the sin of the world. Not love as we know it. How many of us would die for our friends? Well, Jesus died for us while we were still sinners. And still rebellion before God, and he still died for us. That's how much he loves us. Hallelujah. Jesus does love you. As I've just testified, the holy books testify of Jesus' death and resurrection. Will you believe that report? Will you believe that Jesus died for your sin to redeem your soul from death and hell? Do you believe it or do you not? If you believe it, you shall be born again. You shall ask Jesus into your life to be your King, to be your Lord, because he is the King already. He is the Creator of the universe already. He's referred to in the Bible as the Word of God, and even in the Quran as the Word of God as well. Both of these testify who Jesus is, the Word of God. In other words, when God has a thought,
Jesus speaks it. Jesus speaks it forth. Okay? Jesus speaks God's will forward. And he appoints people to do the Father's will. Are you willing to do God's will? He came and taught us how to pray, our Father who art in heaven. Hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done. Jesus said, only those who do the will of my Father shall come into my kingdom. We must be about doing the will of God. It's not enough going to a church. It's not enough maybe just reading the Bible once a week every so often. It's not enough. Even if you're a Christian, you have to give your life to Jesus. You have to give him your all. What's that? Your mass? Mass falling. I've never heard of that. Not at all. I don't need that stuff. You know what I mean? I'm high in the Lord. I'm high in the Holy Spirit. Don't need drugs. My drug is God himself. Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
North Africa, everybody says all the time. When I come to Scotland, it's definitely silence. God is good all the time. He is good all the time. Otherwise, you wouldn't be here. God is feeding you, clothing you, directing your path. But the only path to salvation is through the Lord Jesus Christ. That's the path that the prince of this world does not want you to take. He wants you to try and work out your life for yourself, go to your career advisors, do what you think is right. He doesn't want you to take that dangerous path towards salvation. In fact, Jesus has done it all for you. Jesus laid his life down for you. Jesus already died for you. It says that the good shepherd defends his flock. And that's exactly what Jesus is doing, because he's alive today. He's not a dead Messiah. He's not a dead religious leader. He's alive. He's the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords in heaven. The angels worship and adore him. And so do the saints. And he's calling you in. He's calling you home, basically. Home isn't a church. Home is heaven, where Jesus is, where your Father is. Now, if you don't want to be with him, there is a place called hell, where none of the heavenly angels are in hell. God is not there. And that's where people that do not want God go to. They don't believe in the report in Isaiah 53 that talks about Jesus being the suffering servant, taking the punishment for your sin upon him. That's what Jesus did for us. Don't realize the love that God has for us. He gave us salvation. He gave us health. Hallelujah. Just have faith in him. Say a faith prayer and he'll heal you. He will heal you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. How many of us have given their lives to God? Recognize the sacrifice that Jesus Christ did on the cross. Recognize who he is. According to the Word of God, he is the Word of God, and he laid his life down for you to redeem your soul out of death and hell. And Jesus says, I came to give you life in abundance. I didn't come to condemn you, because you're already condemned in your sins. And Jesus said, unless you believe that I am he, you shall die in your sins. That's what he said. Unless you believe that I am he, you shall die in your sins. And you know what happens if you die in your sins? You go to hell as well. It's not a very pleasant thing. There's a lot of nice people in hell. There's a lot of people in hell that wonder why they're there. And they're just wondering, you know, we were good people. But then the Spirit of God comes and convicts them and says, well, you didn't really love God. You didn't follow God. You didn't do his commandments. You didn't bow before his throne. You didn't like the preaching of the word. You didn't read the Bible. You didn't even read the Quran. You didn't even read your holy book, which talks about Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Which talks about who Jesus Christ is. You know, the many surahs in there, Surah 355, Surah 1933, all of them talking about Jesus' death and resurrection. Even in that book. Even in there. And it does talk about it in the Bible, the Old Testament.
Yeah, we don't need tickets.
Christians have the New Testament. If you're a Christian, have you read the New Testament? Have you read your Bible? It's very important. You have four things which save your soul in the end. It's faith through Jesus Christ. It's the blood of Jesus Christ, which atones for your sin. It's the written word of God. And Jesus Christ himself is the living testimony of the word of God. Make a contract with somebody, you get it in writing. So that's what the Bible is. It's a written covenant between you and God. And when you start reading that covenant, it's up to you whether you want to enter into that covenant through the blood of Jesus Christ. Any covenant that God ever made was by blood. And the blood of the Lamb that was shed at the cross of Calvary is the witness and testament of the new covenant.